फिर
I now a very very good afternoon to all the lovely ladies here, and thank you for joining me today. Margaret Thatcher said, "In politics, if you want something said, say it to a man. If you want something done, say it to a woman." So I am very glad. Today I'm talking to women because I know they can make a big difference. Okay. Many people, especially ignorant people, want to punish you for speaking the truth, for being correct, for being you. Never apologize for being correct or being years ahead of your time. If you are right and you know it, speak your mind. Even if you are a minority of one, the truth is still the truth. Mahatma Gandhi. So, at the very beginning of this presentation, let me make a disclaimer. I am not here, or my little team here is not against any cellular company. And we are certainly here not to tell you that you have to throw away your cell phones. No. We just want to draw your attention to certain aspects of radiation that we may be overlooking these days. So today's presentation, what I really want you to take home is that long-term overexposure to EMF radiation, that's electromagnetic field radiation, will damage your health. And you must be smarter than your smartphone. Okay? So how many of the ladies have their cell phones here today? Silly question to ask in a moment. Okay, how many of you have two cell phones here? Alright, those who have one cell phone will pay attention. And those who have two cell phones will pay double the attention. Okay? Alright, let's just begin with how does a cell phone work? Alright, so you have your cell phone, it is powered by battery. You know, you charge it with electricity. There's a certain technology, and when you dial a couple of numbers, what does it do? It sends out a signal in the air to the nearest antenna. From that antenna goes another signal in the air to another antenna, to another antenna, to another antenna, till they have found the number that you dialed out. So the closest antenna to that phone connects to that phone with another wave in the air. All this is happening in the air. There are waves shooting. When that number has been found and this connection is established, on these waves in the air, your voice will travel back and forth. Okay, so let's just think about this. You dial a number here in Mumbai and you dial out to your friend who is in a mall in Delhi. You've dialed out. In seconds, these waves have shot in the air, gone through antennas, possibly also switching center, some computers, some fiber optics, and reached your friend in Delhi. She's in some mall shopping in Louis Vuitton. But they found her. It's happening in seconds. In seconds. And once this call is established, there is not even a second's, what do you say, delay in the voice traveling. So how fast is all this moving? How fast? It's an amazing technology. It's an amazing technology. It's not to be fooled around with. It's not a toy. Okay. So these waves in the air, how are they created? Man figured out how to make these waves in the air. It's a technology a tool powered by electricity or battery can create waves in the air. What I want you to know is that radio waves, these waves in the air that are being used for cell phones, are closest in range to microwaves. They're closest in range to microwaves. Now, where did we last hear microwaves? Microwave ovens. Everybody's familiar with those. I'm hoping a lot of you don't have them at home. Do you? You do. You don't use it for okay. But that's it. At least you're familiar with microwave ovens. How does that microwave oven work? There is no fire. And yet, the food in the microwave oven heats up. Now, how is this happening? Again, it's a microwave oven. It's a tool, a technology running in that little box. It's powered by electricity and it creates waves inside that box, right? And what those waves inside that box do is they make the molecules of your food vibrate faster. As it is, the molecules were vibrating. We all have molecules. Molecules is, let's say, it's the smallest part of any being. So, for an example, this building. So the smallest part of this building would be, say, a brick. So similarly, our bodies, the smallest particle would be a cell. So the molecules of the food, and all of these cells, they vibrate. They will vibrate faster. Let me take you a little more in a flashback to school. If we remember, we learned, so air molecules, the molecules are far away. So if you put even a little, if you irritate them even a little, they will vibrate faster because there's a lot of space. Liquid molecules are a little more packed. That's why liquid is a liquid. It's a little more packed, needs a little more irritation, and then those molecules will vibrate faster. In a solid like this table here, the molecules are very densely packed. There's no place to move. So it will take a little more of irritation to make them move very fast and create heat in this. So air, because there's a lot of space, will heat up fast, very fast. Liquids will take a little more time, and solids like this will take a lot more time. That's why if you put food into an oven, a microwave oven, the dish will take longer to heat up than the little soft food or the curry that you put inside. Yes? Normally when you use a microwave oven, you will heat the food for what? A minute? 2 minutes? Now what if you heat that food for 2 hours?